Hi, AT from CNC at Home. It's graduation time of year, and I get invited to a few graduation parties and can't go to all of them, can't get gifts for all of them or cards. There are a few special graduations that I'd like to go to, and I do like to take a special gift if I can create one or have time to do one. And a friend of mine has their youngest daughter graduating. Actually, she's already graduated, and she's a saxophone player. So what I want to do is make a set of coasters, and each one would have a different saxophone on it. So this will be a set of four coasters. There will be a soprano, alto, baritone, and tenor saxophones, one on each one of the tiles. And this will just be a real basic, take a white tile, paint it white, and then do a burn of each one of the saxophones on the tile. I already have the tile set to go. I already have the images of the saxophones ready to go from a project I did quite some time ago. So all I really need to do is go into LightBurn, do a little manipulation, bring the images in and adjust them and send them to the laser. So let's start with LightBurn and see what I've done there.
With any tile project, I always start with my 108mm template. So we'll get that open here. We have a 108mm template down here. Since I'm going to do four tiles, I want to burn them all at the same time. I'm going to grid this out. When I grid, I will set both X and Y to 2. And I'm going to use 1.5mm separation between each of those. That's approximately what the separation is between the tiles. It doesn't need to be exact, it just needs to be close enough for this. Now we've got our working area. So let's place the instruments on each of these tile areas. We'll start with the alto sax. We'll place it here. It's way too big. So let's make that a little smaller. And we'll grab it by the center and center it in the tile. See how it snapped? Let's grab the berry. We'll do the same thing. And notice how we have the anchor set to the middle. So when I shrink it down, it shrinks relative to the center, not one of the corners. And then watch as this snaps right into the center there. Boom. Okay. Let's do the tenor saxophone next. Get that shrunk up and get that centered in the working area for that tile. And finally, the soprano saxophone, shrink that and get it centered into the last tile area. Normally, I would consider this done, and I could continue on to the burn. I'm going to go ahead and save this, though, to make sure I have this. We'll get this saved into my instrument area as, call it four sax. Now, I've burned these before, and I know that both the berry and the soprano come out a little bit too light, and they don't burn as well. So I need to go into the settings for those images and change that. So by pressing the Alt-I, it brings up the image control. I can also go under Tools and select Adjust Image, and that brings up the Alt-I screen as well. And I can make several different changes to the image here. Let's full screen that, and so we can see. I'm going to take that brightness and bring it down to about minus 10, and that darkens the image up so that it should burn much better. I'm going to do the same thing to the berry sax, get that set to minus 10. And let's take a look at the preview real quick to see if they look similar to the alto and the tenor. Full screen that and zoom in so we can see what's going on. Ooh, a little too close. Okay, there we go. Now you can see that the berry and the alto are about the same brightness, so I'm confident that that will burn well. We can see that the soprano is much darker, and that should burn really well. So those look good. So we'll go with those settings for now. The next thing we need to do is make sure that we have our burn parameters set correctly. So for that layer, I'm going to go to my little library here and go to white tile. I think we're at, yep, down here at the bottom, and select the burn image that I have. Okay, so we have 1200 millimeters per minute and 85% power. I want to change the resolution a little bit here. I'm going to tighten that down. I'm going to use 350 dpi because that seems to work fairly well for burning images on my laser. Oh, and I want to group these so they burn each saxophone independently. There we go. Now let's take a look at the preview and we'll see how that burns. So as it's burning, it'll do the whole alto saxophone first, then the tenor, then the soprano, and finally the bari. Yeah, it looks like that's going to take just over an hour to burn, so not bad. So about 15 minutes per tile. We'll go ahead and save that again. And now we're ready to send that to the laser. So let's go over to the laser, get that set up, and get ready to burn. Before doing a burn, I use the frame option within LightBurn to see exactly how this is going to burn. By holding the shift key while I press the frame button, it turns the laser on and it will give me a nice frame around what's going to be burned. Through the miracle of modern video editing, we were able to take that 1 hour burn and show it in about a minute. Here I'm engraving the back of each of the tiles. I'm putting on the date, the name of the burn, and the name of the person I'm giving it to. So we'll take a close look here in just a second. Here's the front of the tiles all cleaned up. They worked out really nicely. And on the back, if we can just zoom in on this, we can see that I have a date, it says four sacks, and then Galina, who is the person that I'll be giving these tiles to. Okay, those look nice. The next step is to put a cork back on each one of these. So we'll just flip that over and position a cork on there. These already have self-adhesive on there. I just peel the backing off and stick them on. So we peel the backing off, stick it on the tile, and do that for each one of these. To make sure that these get branded properly for the CNC at Home channel, the next step will be to take them back to the laser and put the CNC logo on there. I showed how to do this in a previous video, so if you just click on the link above, you can go see how this is all done. Well, these tiles turned out really well. They'll make great coasters for Galina. If you like our content, think about liking this video and subscribing. It helps the channel out. Enjoy your CNC at Home projects.
Oops.